Good morning, everyone, and welcome to the next installment of Let's Play Deus Ex. Today, we're going to cover Paris, Champs-Elysses, under martial law, and I think we'll go ahead and do Chateau DuClare as well. So, let's get started. We left off in the sewers after escaping the catacombs.
Above, I'm showing MJ-12 troops and the Paris police. Also some bots. The police won't bother you, but stay away from the troopers.
I actually think we are free to run around in the sewers now that I think about it. But while we're down here, you can find a crowbar and a lockpick. If you head all the way right, you reach one exit of the sewers that would take two lockpicks to open. Let's head left from the entrance tunnel instead. We head over here. We find a more immediate exit that I think is more dangerous, but also more rewarding.
The government has restricted access to the metro. You'll have to get around on foot.
And there's a military bot over there. Looks like over here we've got three troopers and a dog, all hostile to me. And two commandos and another trooper over there. And another military bot. This is gonna be fun. Well, the first order of business is to take down the commandos because they're not affected by gas grenades or any of those other goodies. I wonder if I'm clear of the bot right here. Let's find out. With that bot removed, and it's seemingly no one cares, we can proceed. This commando all the way down here, he's made himself our next target.
Contact. I've got contact.
I will, of course, have to pull off the one-shock takedown. I know from experience it's possible, so I'm not too worried.
Contact. I've got contact.
Just need it to work. He's got nothing worth picking up, apparently. Pistol ammo in that crate. Let's keep going down this way. Thank you. commando. I wonder if I manage a one-hit takedown with the baton. If I can do it without alerting everyone else. I cannot. I think the answer here is gonna have to be a gas grenade with four different people. But before I do that, I need to eliminate the other commando with my good old-fashioned riot prod. Hopefully, I can creep over there without aggravating the other guys. We're in a pretty deep shadow, but that might be compromised when we get over here. We'll find out.
Not sure what you might find in these buildings, but if you break and enter, be prepared to deal with the Paris police.
Okay. Let's try and tag this guy now. Got him. Excellent. Now he's not carrying anything either. Now I want to get this patroller. And then finally we'll go after the group of guys with a gas grenade. That's not gonna work. Yeah, I should have expected that. There's a way to get these guys, there has to be. That's not working. So now we get back around to the other side of these fellows. Now I'll try the gas grenade again. Hold on, I have to reset my... There we go. My walk control got confused. Sorry about that. Alright, let's try again. I just need to get a better throw. There we go. I thought the rifle method walked into the gas. Seems I was wrong about that. Still, that will work. I just need to execute better.
God!
There. Should have gone after him as soon as he stepped into the cloud. Okay, we got all four. But of course, I got set on fire. Troopers. Now I just have to track down the dog. Good! Everything's handled. I'm sure none of the troopers have anything I actually want, but let's search them anyway. Assault rifle, knife, EMP grenade. He has a flamethrower. He has tranquilizer darts. He has more tranquilizer darts and a law. So actually, the EMP grenade and the trank darts are both good finds. Alright. With all that accomplished... First, let me just point out the other exit of the sewers would spit us out right here. We'll clear this street next, but before we do that, let's explore this little guard room. We get 50 skill points for coming in here, which brings me to 2276. There's a lamb in the crate, a biocell on the desk. A data cube. Welcome to Paris, the City of Lights. This map will help to familiarize you with the Champs-Elysees, the spiritual and cultural heart of the city. During the day, the Champs-Elysees is a bustling street of boutiques and government offices, but it is only at night that it comes truly alive, a place of cafes and clubs, of theaters and cabaret. While many visitors only see the glittering main avenue, those who are a bit more adventurous might venture off the beaten path and be rewarded with a taste of old Paris and the dark back streets and alleys, away from the flashing lights and hustle of tourists. I think it gave us an... Oh, it didn't give us an image. Lame. And let's hack the computer. We can deactivate the patrol bots, but what fun would that be? There's no email. This one has wandered off by itself. Foolish. It's going to be destroyed. With that done, I see another commando wandering our direction, so there's a soda and a soy food and a bottle of wine back here, but I want to get the drop on that commando and take him down.
Clear the streets.
Normal Paris police officers don't start out hostile, but they'll turn that way if they I think... Tracer mentioned if you break into, you know, Paris residences, and they may turn hostile if they see you drop someone like I'm about to do. Let's find out. Yes. That's what I thought.
Clear the streets.
So let's drop the cop first.
The metro is closed until further notice.
After we talk to him.
Remember to stay within your arrondissement after dark. The security boats have been given the faces of over 1,000 terrorists. The city will not take responsibility for mistaken identity. You would be safest in your place of residence. We have asked business owners to close down. Tonight is not the best night to enjoy Paris. Tourists must also obey the security restrictions. Stay aware of your surroundings at all times. The new government does not provide us with specific information to share with the public. We have been told only that the danger to the public today is high. The new government does not provide us with specific information to share with the public.
Alright, let's drop him. Oh, he was carrying a reload mod, which we can put into our mini crossbow. Drop the reload time to 1 second. Not bad. So let's stash his body someplace. Obviously, we're going to break and enter, so we'll end up turning these guys hostile anyway. I think I can still get the drop on this commando before he gets back to his buddies. Bam. All right, let's continue. Dropped another cop. That one was carrying an assault shotgun.
Mm-hmm.
that's Club La Porte de l'Enfer. If you've watched the rest of this Let's Play, you should know that that will be, end up being the last place we go.
Strange. I'm picking up infrared pulses. Why would a bakery need electronic security?
Tracer, you talk too much. You're bothering me. Oh, good. If this guy comes back here, he'll be easy to drop. A sawed-off shotgun. Let's head around the other side. I think that'll be... that'll just be better. After the streets are clear, I'll start sweeping buildings. I was worried that other trooper might spot me, and he did. Let's try again now. Nope, they both saw that. I need a better plan for these guys. Let's watch where they actually walk. Okay. I think the one with the shotgun is gonna walk a loop all the way around the metro entrance. The one with the crossbow is walking a small loop back and forth across the street. I should still be able to take down the commando now that the other guy's farther away. Commando has nothing. This guy has a med kit, tranquilizer darts, and a knife. Sawed-off shotgun, combat knife, and a scope. I believe all of those are useless to me. Let's read this newspaper while we're here. Police raid catacombs. I think we saw that already. Get this
clear
cop.
The streets.
He has an assault shotgun and a med kit. Guess I can go ahead and bust open this crate. Ballistic armor. Nothing down Metro Way. I don't think there's anything in this structure either. Let's talk to the chef.
If you want a job, talk to Christy. The chef already has an assistant, me. With business the way it is, because of the soldiers scaring everybody, we won't be hiring anybody soon. This is a very difficult job, not for everyone. I don't think you would work out. The chef has exacting tests. I must get back to work.
All right, now as we head over here, we find a bot and a couple more cops.
New travel restrictions. Consult the papers.
I want to drop the cops and the bot, of course.
Good God!
He must have been a terrorist.
Huh. That was funny. Alright, well, let's be a little more careful and see. Looks like that one is stationary and that one's a wanderer. Of course, I have the hostile bot to consider. Smart play might be to take the bot out first, but we'll see.
Clear the streets.
Think I can get both those guys without any fuss. And then, of course, we can go ahead and get the bot. Alright. That guy's got nothing. He had a sawed-off shotgun. Let's check out this street now. We've got two ATMs. Which I'll go ahead and hack. 750 credits in this one. Zero credits in this one. And two public access terminals. It's the same as the one we've already seen. Yeah, no changes, nothing new. Now let me get a grip on exactly where we are. Very good. Nothing back here. Over here we've got a couple of crates with pistol ammo and tech goggles. Now we're ready to explore back here behind these buildings. Clear out any remaining bad guys. I think we're just about clear. There might be a couple of cops left, but that should be all.
Can I ask you a question?
I am not paid to advise tourists.
Take it easy. I just want to know if you've heard of Nicolette DuClare.
I have no dealings with Miss DuClare. I sweep the streets. That is my life.
But you know her? Where would she be this time of night?
I don't have money to waste on that place. Number 13. Club La Porte de l'Enfer. A private club for rich phonies.
Number 13. Thanks.
If you want Renault, he is in the bar at the hostel.
Great. What would I want with Renault?
You aren't who he was going to hire. The professional thief?
I'm flattered.
I got two notes. Number 13, the street address of La Porte de la Club La Porte de l'Enfer, And a guy named Renault, located in the hostel's bar, is looking to hire a professional thief.
Enough talk. I do not want to know about your business. My job was cleaning up the streets. Now, I hide from security forces. They still send the money every month, so I don't complain. Enough talk.
Alright, that heads back out to the main street we already cleared. We head over here. I see at least one more cop.
These flats go for about 5,000. Almost as bad as Hong Kong.
Well, I see one cop standing here, so we'll go ahead and drop him.
New travel restrictions. Consult the papers.
Very good. He's not carrying anything. Ah, yes, there's another one over here. Go ahead and drop him as well.
Sir, what is your business tonight?
He's not carrying anything either. And with that, the streets are clear. I'm going to start off in the hostel, number 10.
That little building is a hostel. Lodging for backpackers.
Got another cop in here.
Not a good night to be on the street.
So I'd better drop him. He's got a sawed-off shotgun, a candy bar, and some binoculars. All useless to me. Now let's...
Sorry, all full tonight.
Don't need a room, but maybe you can help me find a member of the group Silhouette. Her name's Nicolette DuClare.
No, I know nothing about that. Leave me alone.
Let's hack this computer. No email.
I never heard of anything called Silhouette. I mind my own business. As you see, we rent a decent hotel, but we do not know everything about our tenants. As you see, we rent a decent hotel, but we do not know everything about our tenants.
I think these are the same. We'll go upstairs second. We'll check down here first. Let's talk to Renault and his bodyguard.
Hello.
Talk to Renault.
Yeah. Hello.
You must be Renault.
So?
I heard you're looking to hire a thief.
The baker at number 15 keeps Zyme. 100% pure. In one of the ovens.
What do I get if I help you?
50 credits each vial. The place has booby traps. Otherwise, I would break in myself.
I'll check out the bakery.
Like I said, building 15.
Right.
So I got a new secondary goal. Get the Zyme from the bakery and sell it to Renault. And, a note, the baker at number 15 has a stash of Zyme in one of the ovens. Pretty straightforward.
The bakery is owned by Sicilians. This is how they do drop-offs in the Champs-Elysees. Speak.
Okay. I'll check it.
Like I said.
Right.
Okay, let's talk to the bartender.
Be careful of those two. They are felons.
I gathered.
I am serious. Do not give them your name or where you live. Can I get you something to drink? Wine is 120, snacks are 5.
Heard of Nicolette DuClare?
No, I am sorry. Is she a guest of the hotel?
A member of Silhouette.
You want Club La Porte de l'Enfer. No revolutionaries here.
Where's that?
Number 13, I believe.
New note. Address of club number 13.
Yes?
No revolutionaries? You must not mind martial law.
the only way to maintain order.
Don't you miss using the metro?
A small inconvenience. The city must be kept safe for those of us who are working and trying to pull the country out of this depression.
What if I told you that the depression was caused by a cabal of wealthy businessmen who want to rule the world?
These stories, I hear them every day. Always from someone who wants to blame other people for his bad luck. Yes?
The conspiracy is real.
And I bet you have a little booklet that will tell me all about it, no?
They call themselves Majestic 12.
Good. I was afraid you were going to tell me about the Illuminati.
They were once part of the Illuminati, but they rebelled.
Oh, I see. Yes?
Never mind.
I rather like that scene. We got a hotel key.
Excusez-moi. I clean all of the rooms every day. The front desk is downstairs. No danger of parasites. We have a bar, too, downstairs in the back. I clean all of the rooms every day.
Alright, nothing in there. We did just find the key to this door. There's a book. We've read this already, Petals of Twilight.
Observe your motivations for breaking the arbitrary laws of current governments. Do not miss your chance to be one of us and create a new world order.
Up here, we have a bioelectric cell. 100 credits. And a data cube. I was at Port de l'Enfer last night and managed to get some stupid American to buy me a drink, then peeked his code when he wasn't looking. Do me a favor, pull some cash from his account and get your petite amie to pick me up some Zyme. It is fabulous, the new thing from New York. 004418 Morbus 13. Bonsoir. Anne. I don't know what happened to the music, but it's weirding me out. It sounds like the Game Over music. But I don't think it is. Anyway, we'll go ahead and tackle the bakery next, since it is right here. Two picks, three picks, an alarm sounds if we break the window, but of course, nobody's around to care. Lock pick. Got 50 skill points for getting close to the oven. The oven's got another 100 credits. 6 vials of Zyme. The other oven has a plasma clip, a PS20, and 2 clips of pistol ammo. And the counter's got a newspaper. Bot kills 3 in accidental shooting, APR Paris, France. Yves Pierre Adrian, Dominique Vite, and Marie Philibert were heading home from a late night on the town when they were gunned down in the street by a military bot that mistakenly identified them as terrorists. Since the institution of martial law in Paris, bots have regularly patrolled those areas with a high level of criminal activity, armed with a visual database profiling thousands of wanted terrorists, thieves, and drug dealers. It was awful, said Christy Amiel, a waitress at Enfant Terrible, a nearby cafe where the trio had their last cup of coffee. She was witness to the shooting. The bot just kept shooting and shooting until all you could hear was an empty clicking sound. Then one of the soldiers ran into the control station across the street trying to shut it down, but nothing happened. It just kept clicking, trying to shoot them again. Police Prefect Hubert Dupuy defended the practice during a news conference earlier today. The bots are programmed to only use lethal force if the subjects resist arrest, and while these deaths are tragedies to be mourned, it in no way compromises the effectiveness of bots in keeping Parisians safe. Alright. And with that nasty bit of business done, let's head back to the hostel and talk to Renault again. Now, I've been hoarding Zyme the whole game. This is the guy who will buy it all off of me.
I busted into the bakery.
Excellent. Now do we make a deal? 50 apiece?
I'll make the trade.
Never mind the bartender. He's cool.
Here. Take it.
Good job. We must work together again when I find out where they will move the drop-off.
I'll be out of town, but thanks for the cash.
So he took all our Zyme and gave us 50 credits for all of it, for each vial. Pretty good, if you ask me. Now then, let's go ahead and do these. 11 and 12. Take four lockpicks. Should be obvious by now, I'm just gonna blow the door. We get 50 skill points for coming in here. Brings my total to 2376. I think this dog is gonna attack me as soon as I come in. Oh, maybe not. Anyway, this is the house of a weapons dealer. He's got two throwing knives, an assault shotgun, a bottle of wine, a range modification, which I guess I'll stick on the Gep gun, sabot rounds, an accuracy modification, which I have no use for.
Come with me to America. Says I can bring one person.
The United States is no fun. What about a coup attempt?
Think about it, though. A small town in the Rocky Mountains, we would be together.
Oh, yes, we could find the terrorists that attacked the White House. They could terrorize me and you could help.
And be serious. The people are well organized in the Mountain States. They are justified in attacking the government. We will go to the Northwest.
That's next door. And over here, they're throwing knives at 100 credits.
I'm not prepared for the rugged life in the mountains.
And I am?
We're young, Hope. We are ready to wrestle grizzly bears if we have to.
My dear, grizzly bears have been extinct for decades.
You know what I mean.
Always so romantic. You never let real life interfere with your plans.
It would be a test. You are always wanting. The test of your love.
That crate has a plasma rifle in it. We've got a data key. We've got some rockets here by the bed on the nightstand. Data cube. Metropolitan Bank of Paris. 1 Rue d'Astor, established 1834. Dear customer, a recent hacking attempt has made it necessary to change the passwords on a number of our accounts to ensure the security of our patrons. Please note that your account has in no way been compromised. This is merely a precaution. If you have any questions, please feel... I assume they're leaving out a free, but it says, please feel to contact a Metropolitan Bank customer care advocate. Account 005133, PIN Salem 008. Thank you, Metropolitan Bank. There's a book on the bed, Common Sense by Thomas Paine. Some writers have so confounded society with government as to leave little or no distinction between them, whereas they are not only different but have different origins. Society is produced by our wants, and government by wickedness. The former promotes our happiness positively by uniting our affections, the latter negatively by restraining our vices. The one encourages intercourse, the other creates distinctions. The first is a patron, the last a punisher. Society in every state is a blessing, but government, even in its best state, is but a necessary evil, in its worst state, an intolerable one. For when we suffer, or are exposed to the same miseries by a government, which we might expect in a country without government, our calamity is heightened by reflecting that we furnish the means by which we suffer. Government, like dress, is the badge of lost innocence. The palaces of kings are built on the ruins of the bowers of paradise. For were the impulses of conscience clear, uniform, and irresistibly obeyed, man would need no other lawgiver. But that not being the case, he finds it necessary to surrender up a part of his property to furnish means for the protection of the rest. And this he is induced to do by the same prudence which in every other case advises him out of two evils to choose the least. And finally, I'm gonna try and herd the dog out of here because I need to blow open that box. I don't want to kill the poor little fella. Come on, go back to the other room, buddy. Well, that might be good enough. Nope. Now let me see if there's anything in here I need, anyway. Plasma clips, a clip modification, sniper ammo, and a laser modification. I don't need any of it. Oh, good, we fixed the music. Should have done that sooner. Anyway, let's check out 12 now, where Renee and O were chatting with each other. Two lockpicks or blow the door. To me, the choice is obvious. See, they've got some cigarettes. I think Renee does eventually attack me if I stay inside here too long. But there's a book on their shelf. The Eye of Argon by Jim Tice. The weather-beaten trail wound ahead into the dust-racked climes of the barren land which dominates large portions of the Norgolian Empire. Age-worn hoofprints, smothered by the sifting sands of time, shone dully against the dust-splattered crust of Earth. The tireless sun cast its parching rays of incandescence from overhead, halfway through its daily revolution. Small rodents scampered about, occupying themselves in the daily accomplishments of their dismal lives. Dust sprayed over three heaving mounts in blinding clouds while they bore the burdensome cargoes of their struggling overseers. Prepare to embrace your creators in the Stygian haunts of hell, barbarian, gasped the first soldier. Only after you have kissed the fleeting steed of death, wretch, returned Grigner. All right. Let's talk to these two now.
If you're looking for that crook with the weapons, he lives next door. Okay, time for you to go. This is what would happen. Finding nothing but pine cones and snow in the mountains, we would take a bus to one of the cities and stand in line for sandwiches. Leave us alone. Leave us alone.
All right, let's try talking to Renee.
Hey, this is our apartment. S'il vous plaît. I said get out.
All Alright, neither O nor Renee are carrying anything. Let's go upstairs. They've got a cat. One lockpick. Yeah, I'll go ahead and burn that. We've got 200 credits and a new data cube. Metropolitan Bank of Paris, 1 Rue d'Astor, established 1834. Dear customer, a recent hacking attempt has made it necessary to change the passwords on a number of our accounts to ensure the security of our patrons. Please note that your account has in no way been compromised. This is merely a precaution. If you have any questions, please feel free to contact a Metropolitan Bank customer care advocate. Account 002639, PIN Aramis 01. Thank you, Metropolitan Bank. All right. Now in the bedroom, I've gotten in the habit of checking under pillows. There is a biocell under the bed. The bathroom is empty. Got another credit chit on this table, worth 100, along with a pepper gun. The main reason to come in here, of course. When we get out onto the balcony, we get 50 more skill points. Up to 2426. Awesome. Up here, we got binoculars and a multi-tool. Nothing left. Time to go. Now 13 is Club La Porte de l'Enfer. Obviously we're not ready to go there yet. I don't think there's any way into this building. Or Tree Chic. But we can get into... We need to go into Enfant Terrible. And we need to go into this electronics store. We'll do that first.
A digital media store. Don't waste your money in those places. You can get anything you want for 2 credits on the black market in Asia.
Ah, Tracer. Encouraging piracy. This game came out, what, 12 years ago? I know. There's a lockpick, I think, down in the sewers. YJC is swimming as though he lost his running legs. I do not know. But it doesn't matter much. We're just down here to get back the lockpick that we used. All right. Now we'll bust into that store. I'm still just gonna blow the door. I find that preferable to using 2 lockpicks. There's a multi-tool on top of one of the shelves. I've got 50 more skill points for coming in here. Brings me up to 2476. And since there's an ATM I haven't hacked yet, I can use all these PIT accounts and passwords I just found. So we got 004418 Morbus 13. 004418 Morbus 13. That one's worth 100 credits. I've got 2 more. We got 00513 Salem 008. So 005133 Salem 008. It says minus 550. Guess that means that account is rather in debt. Finally, we've got Renee and O, 002639 Aramis 01. 002639 Aramis 01. They've got 150 credits. And last, we'll hack. Minus 250. How odd. Anyway, let's go into the cafe now.
Ah, the Paris nightlife. Have a taste of wine for me, JC.
We'll talk to this family first. I'm gonna save Jaime for last.
He's our son. We can't have him murdering people from this majestic 12.
He's not a child anymore.
This cult?
At least he has a position. He's safe.
Any organization with anonymous leadership.
They might control Europe for decades. Michelle will have to survive somehow.
I would rather he die with the rest of us.
Joshua!
Bonjour, monsieur.
First and in your heart, you are a father. How dare you let politics...
I am a Frenchman.
You have abandoned your own son.
Perhaps I want to take the metro to see my mother, yes? Should I forget mother and my own freedom to travel so that Michelle can have a small salary?
These are difficult times, I don't deny it.
He and his new friends murdered the Loredans simply because the old man ran a journal. Next time, he will come to murder us.
Papa forbids me to talk to strangers. Leave me alone. Leave me alone.
I couldn't help overhearing about your son.
The others, yes. Majestic 12. Whoever they are. When you have the use, you have everything.
Joshua, be careful. You don't know this man.
I will not hide under a rock.
You have nothing to fear. I would like to see the end of Majestic 12 as much as you would. I was just surprised to find a Parisian who has heard the name.
Well, my son, you know. I learn what I can about him.
What else have you found out?
You are one of the revolutionaries, huh? Maybe you can do something with this. Street Station 17 and Werewolf from a card in his wallet. I think it is the logging for the guard shack up the street.
What about Michelle? You'll get him killed!
He was the one who wanted to be a soldier.
New note. Security Station login, Street Station 17, password Werewolf. Awesome.
You've done enough. Go. Oh, poor Michelle. If you see him, tall, you know, dark hair, don't shoot. He's our child. I know, they all look the same in those uniforms. Oh, poor Michelle.
That is what I know. I have helped you to kill my own son. Is that not enough? I said go. I have helped you to kill my own son. Is that me?
What would you like? Everything, 10 credits.
At least one cafe stayed open during the crackdown.
We will never close, no matter what.
Is there some kind of curfew?
Not yet, but the police programmed the bots to shoot anyone who leaves his arrondissement after dark.
I'm looking for a friend, Nicolette DuClare.
A leader of silhouette, a true patriot.
Know where I might find her?
Where the criminals and students go at night, La Porte de l'Enfer, just across the street.
Thanks. This crackdown is the work of Majestic 12.
You mean the European Union?
They are a group of conspirators who have been seizing governments all over the world.
I don't care what they call themselves. I have seen it since I was a girl, the plotting and scheming of corporations to make Europe into one big country with no separate languages, cultures, or tastes.
It's more than Europe they plan to unify. Never mind.
Somnolente Isle scandal resurfaces. Paris investigateur. Accusations of cover-ups within President Bourges Maunoury's administration have recently appeared in several tabloid publications, linking key members of his Council of Ministers to the Somnolente Isle scandal that resulted in President Serra's exit from politics 5 years ago. Somnolente Isle, an exclusive resort in Côte d'Azur, was the site of a clandestine meeting between then-President Serra and reputed members of the Zouganoff crime family in an attempt to funnel almost 3 billion credits of tainted money through French banks. The deal was reportedly brokered by a cabal of major banking interests, including deceased financier Beth DuClare, though her involvement was never proved. Some sources went so far as to suggest that the entire meeting was the result of a plot hatched by the Bilderbergs, a supposedly secret society formed of wealthy and powerful industrialists shortly after World War II. President Bourges Maunoury has dismissed the accusations as ludicrous, calling such stories the lowest example of irresponsible journalism before refusing further comment. Back here, we find an exit back to the streets. Inside here, there's another chef to talk to, and yes, there's the data cube. Navi 008-Blue V4.28, Obelix. This Navi is the property of Pierre Boulet. If found, please return to Pierre Boulet at 74 Rue Montaigne, or contact pboulet/parisnet.3729.293.834. Tickets for Cavallero Rusticana, 21-7. Meet Tracy at Enfance Terrible, 1830. New CD by Brewer's Phrase. New account, 14th Arrondissement Branch, 001506/Naga066. Chocolate and 34 Seven Crows Established Sauvignon Blanc for Marie. Download Navi 4.31 Security Patch. Alright, let's talk to this guy.
If you have a request, talk to my assistant Raymond. He always seems to be looking for something to do. I'm busy. They will serve you out front. I'm busy.
And finally, let's talk to our good old friend Jaime Reyes.
Thought you could run off for a weekend in Paris without me, huh?
Call me nostalgic, but the nightlife seems to have lost its old charm.
Yes, but I didn't trust anyone else to deliver this warning. Not even Alex or Tom.
What happened at UNATCO?
They intercepted a message Alex sent to my home account. Instructions on how to find him in Hong Kong.
I hope the message was encrypted.
I destroyed my keister. Tong is safe. But they've been tracking you with an AI program. They've sent Gunther to assassinate you in Paris.
Icarus.
However, you don't have to fight Gunther or any other mechanically augmented agent.
Does that mean you know his kill phrase?
Yeah. How do you know about kill phrases? That's Throne 6G information.
I found out from Paul.
Well, here's some God clearance information for you. Dug it out of classified medical records before I left. Gunther's kill phrase is Laputin machine.
Laputin machine. Easy enough. Thanks for looking out for me. Staying at the agency and all.
Don't mention it.
Bam. Gunther kill phrase, Laputin machine.
At the sound of your voice, 400 milliamps will discharge into Gunther's midbrain. Poof. I wasn't the only one who got purged. Carter's gone also. Questionable loyalty. Can you believe that? Carter! I think Simons was afraid he knew too much. All of the older guys were let go. Anyone with non-UNATCO experience. Carter told me he was going to contact Gary Savage of the X-51 researchers. I don't know how they know each other, but Carter said, Savage is right. It's time to do something about Area 51. You know Carter, taciturn as ever. Who knows what he was talking about? I'm going to stay here until the soldiers calm down. I saw Gunther leave the club a few hours ago. I heard he was asking about you. Be careful, JC. I'm going to stay here until the soldiers calm down.
All right. Now with that, we are ready to enter the club. There's a front entrance and a side entrance. I'll walk to the front entrance first.
La Porte de l'Enfer. Resistant members aren't the only ones fond of the discreet staff and plentiful shadows. Watch your back.
Two more public access terminals, but I think they are the same. We can waste 4 lockpicks or an explosive getting through the door. This guy'll want us to pay the cover.
300 credits.
No thanks.
You are not our first choice of customer either.
This is quite a bit easier, if you ask me. I didn't really mean to blow the glass, but oh well.
Get out!
I didn't expect that to be that tough.
$300 credit.
No thanks.
You are not...
There we go. That's what I wanted. So he's got a nightclub door key, a sawed-off shotgun, and a knife. Not interested in the shotgun or the knife. And he's also carrying a lockpick, which I currently have no use for. There's another club main door key. Let's see where this other vent goes first. One of the bathrooms, the ladies' room, looks like.
I know the bathroom is unisex, but just wait a minute, will you? This is shameful. I will bring it up to Mr. Tarot personally. Do you find yourself amusing?
Oh! Oh! Je suis malais. Je suis epileptique. Laissez-moi tranquille. Laissez-moi tranquille.
All right, commenters. Anyone who wants to let me know what she said, that would be awesome. I assume she insulted me. But I'm not sure how. Anyway, there's another vent. Let's see where this one goes. This one's locked, and it looks like it leads to the offices in back. We'll get there eventually. Let's head all the way back to the front entrance and go through it. Now we're in. We get 100 skill points for making it to the dance floor. Brings me up to 2576.
Please, keep your weapons concealed. Obey the rules and enjoy yourself. No fighting. Get a drink, relax, and enjoy yourself. The people who come here prefer to be left alone. Mr. Taro asked that I do not talk to guests. Please, keep your weapons concealed.
Busy night, huh? This place used to be a party. People don't go out anymore. Even my friends in the Champs-Elysees. The coup is such a drag. There's nothing to do anymore. There's nothing to do anymore.
Pretty lady, huh? I love this place. Get down. Go, cat, go. Yeah. A nurse. Loosen up. Yeah.
All right. We'll go ahead and talk to the nurse now.
Hi, baby. What's your name?
JC.
Mysterious. Want to know my initials?
How about you tell me something about the people who come here?
Anything you like, cutie. 20 credits.
Okay.
So, who do you want to find?
What can you tell me about Nicolette DuClare?
I see now. You are in love, you poor man. She has already given her heart to one of the revolutionaries.
I'm not in love. Could you tell me if she's here?
You have a look. He has a tough guy look, but you cannot compare to a real revolutionary. They have their own private society upstairs. You will be happier down here. Another 20 credits?
Sure.
I can tell you about Antoine, the thief.
Go ahead. Should I be keeping an eye on my credit chits?
He pretends to be a big-time smuggler, but really, he just steals things from the augmentation clinic where his mother works.
Everyone's got to start somewhere, I guess.
You will find him lurking in a dark corner. I bet he will try to sell you something. Am I telling you what you want to know? Can I have another 20 credits?
Sure.
Who next? Jacques, the accountant?
I'm not picky. Tell me about Jacques.
He grew up here on the Champs-Elysees. He knows everybody. If you're looking for a particular person...
Where do I find him?
He is in the office behind the South Bar. What do you say? Another 20 credits?
Sure.
This time I tell you about myself.
Okay.
My name is Camille. I'm a writer.
Yeah? What are you doing in a place like this?
I'm working on a novel. If I dress up like a nurse twice a week, I make enough money to write the other 5 days.
Not bad.
Funny how the traffic of credits brings our dreams and fantasies to life. Every transaction is like a small prayer. So many men have a thing for nurses. You can be sure someone will be standing right where I am, collecting the offerings.
Well, I was buying information.
Sure, baby, if you say so. But if my novel ever gets published, that would be 400 pages of pure information. Think you would put down the 10 credits to get it?
I'm not much into books.
Three notes. Silhouette hangs out on the upper level of the club. Antoine is a thief at the club who sells augmentation supplies. And Jacques, the club's accountant, can be found in the office behind the South Bar. He is well informed about the residents of the Champs-Elysées.
You have to share. I must amuse the others now. Come again, same time next week. I must amuse the others now.
All right. Next room. Let's talk to this gal.
Have a light?
I don't smoke.
What's your name?
I'm a little busy right now.
Hey, can I ask a favor? I'm out of money. Have any spare chits?
How does someone with no money get into a club with a 300 credit cover charge?
My friends work here.
Then you must know all about the place.
Oh yes, I used to work in the office. I could tell you anything. How about 200 credits? I could give you the code to the safe room.
What about Nicolette DuClare? Know her?
I don't want to get mixed up in any of that. I stay out of other people's business.
Mixed up in what?
You know how they used to steal sunglasses from the street cops or run by with scissors and cut off their ties? That kind of thing. Always calling attention to themselves.
You mean Silhouette? I think they were trying to save Paris from exactly what's going on right now.
Funny way of doing it, and pretty dangerous. Once people know who you are, you can be killed. Just like that. Just like Nicolette's mother. Enough! I'm not saying her name again.
All right. I'm not interested in buying the code from her. Anyway, there's the main entrance and exit to the bathroom. So we've got a bartender,
Qu'est-ce que je vous sers?
Thin crowd. Has martial law heard business?
Heard business? Heard business? You can even get on the metro. How can you get to the club without the metro?
I came through the catacombs.
Oui, oui. The only way is to crawl on your belly like a stinking rat. That's all we get, stinking rats.
Silhouette members, you mean?
Rats, and the Gestapo, and they want free drinks.
Gestapo?
Not French soldiers. Some of them don't even speak French.
The troops at the metro?
Oui, there was a coup. We see the president only on video recording, and sweat is dripping from his mustache because it's obvious. Someone is pointing a gun at his head.
You might be right about that. Never mind.
Talk to this guy.
Mr. Taro asks that I do not talk to guests.
Alright, before we go back there to the offices, let's explore the other sort of main club rooms.
Obey the rules and enjoy yourself.
Got another bartender here.
What will it be? A snack for 10 credits? Wine for 120?
Know the name Nicolette DuClare?
What do you want with Miss DuClare?
A private matter.
This club has good security. You try something, you won't be arrested. You will be dead.
I'm a friend of hers.
She would have told me to expect you.
What do you think of Silhouette?
They have the right idea, but they are weak.
Do they have much popular support?
The people are ready to fight. Foreign troops go down the street every day, not even afraid of being seen.
The group that has occupied the Chancellery is called Majestic 12. They control the United Nations and plot against other governments as well.
What we need is an army. Silhouettes should be organizing resistance, not spreading around slogans everybody already agrees with.
Never mind.
All right. Let's go talk to these two.
Chad's dead. No. The police are making a clean sweep through the catacombs. He can't hide.
Silhouette knows what to do in these situations.
I told him this would happen. But he would not let go of his Voltaire delusion.
Maybe he is a Voltaire. We don't know.
Was Voltaire.
I have some good news for both of you. Chad's alive.
You seen him? Where? Is he okay?
An American accent. What business do you have with Silhouette?
My business is with the terrorists who control the French government. They're planning the same in my own country.
What would L'Arme de Terre want with America?
The French army had nothing to do with the coup. It was an international paramilitary group called Majestic 12.
Hey, what about Chad? How is he?
His hideout is secure. I'm looking for a friend of his named Nicolette DuClare. She can lead me to a powerful enemy of the conspirators.
Nicolette! Oh yeah, she's here. She...
She does not want to be found.
You know her?
She realizes how foolish it is to antagonize the government and has gone into hiding.
My friend is right. Nicolette told us not to trust anyone. I'm sorry.
Nicolette is in enough trouble as it is.
Chad knows exactly what he is doing. He will be a great hero in French history.
A martyr, maybe. Not a philosopher.
He's quoted all over the world.
Slogans, antiques, no contract social.
Ideas take many forms.
He recycles the past. It is nothing special to be a reactionary who tries to revive the same old rhetoric.
Leave us alone. Political freedom is rhetoric?
A necessary deception of the industrial age.
A realization, rather, of the value of a human life.
Human life was valuable only in one sense. Suddenly, any person was a unit of labor in the factory system, roughly equivalent to all others, and was therefore a transferable resource.
It was the greatest age this planet has ever seen. The age of invention, of self-reliance, of the individual artist.
And transferable resources must be free to move about in response to market forces. That's freedom. Now that most people don't produce anything of value.
We're talking about the inherent worth of an individual, not economic utility.
Now that only a few people create wealth, the scientists, engineers, bankers, and so on, We require an arrangement of the few of the inert mass the rest of us have become.
A nation's government does not have to bow down beneath economic laws.
That is where we differ. I believe the evolution is always in that direction. Leave us alone!
I love the conversations in this game. Anyway, let's talk to this guy now.
Hello, tough guy.
You talking to me?
You use bioelectric devices, yes? Manufacture steroids in your muscles?
Nothing as crude as that.
But yes, you would be interested in a bioelectric cell for 250 credits.
No thanks.
Don't need a bioelectric cell. If he had an upgrade canister, I'd be interested in that. Anyway, let's go to the offices now. You see there the other vent we could have come out of. So this must be Jock the accountant. Notice the PS20. Let's talk to him.
You work here?
The bartender will help you. I am the accountant.
Just a few questions. Have you heard of Silhouette?
So, you're in that game. Don't say a word. I don't want to know. But for 1,000 credits, I'll give you the address of an arms smuggler who is out of town. Do you need guns?
No way.
Talk to me again. I am your man.
We've already been there. He just refers us to apartment 11. Anyway, I want to get in that door, so let's drop Jock. He's got a sawed-off shotgun and a lockpick. Well, looks like I've got to burn a lockpick somewhere. If I want to move him out of the way. We'll go ahead and use one. Pick it up, move his body out of the room. Now I'm just gonna blow the door. Bioelectric cell. That blew open this door too, that's awesome. This is just the back entrance to the club. Yeah, I don't think there's actually anything here. That just spits us out. Back in the alley. The only real attraction back here is this room. She offered to sell us the code, but since I am advanced in electronics, we can just use 2 multi-tools. We get 50 skill points for coming in here, which brings my total to 2626. We got a med kit, darts, prod charger, sniper ammo, basketball, soy food, cigarettes. What's up here? Cigarettes. Wine, 40, wine. Shotgun ammo, 100 credits. Pistol ammo, assault rifle ammo, 40. Tranquilizer darts, flare darts, and thermoptic camo. And we are now ready to go upstairs.
Come on, 200 credits. You will find much more than that in the safe room.
Already been there.
Are you sure?
I broke in myself. Looks like that code isn't going to be as valuable as you thought.
Oh, great. I really hit bottom this time. That was my last chance to make any cash. I hope you're happy.
Maybe you should try getting a job.
As far as I'm concerned, this place could burn down. They said I was stealing, which isn't true. Everybody else was doing exactly the same thing. Oh, They pay you nothing to work here. You can't even live on it. I hope Mr. Taro tries to throw me out. I'd like to see him try. Oh, great jacket. Très chic. They said I was stealing, which isn't true. Everybody...
Pretty lady, huh?
All right, upstairs. Let's go over here first.
Cloud? Oh, sorry, my mistake. Cloud was a friend of mine. Silly of me, I still think I see him sometimes. He got shot by one of the guards here. They've started using real ammunition. It was a mistake. These other people were fighting and Cloud just wanted to get away.
I like the mirror effect in this room.
He had this tough guy look. The guards just assumed. You should be careful, too. Everybody's very tense these days. They think anybody who looks a little funny is a terrorist. You should be careful, too.
All right. We'll leave her for the moment. Let's talk to this guy.
Everything is satisfactory, I trust. We remodeled the upstairs. You may have noticed. Many customers wanted quiet areas where they could talk. I think I finally struck the perfect balance between the Dionysian and Apollonian. What do you think? We get a rather iconoclastic crowd these days. The place does not fill up until very late. I should be getting back to my duties. Pleasure to meet you. Have a good time. Have a good time.
Alright. Now let's talk to this girl.
I'm looking for Nicolette DuClare.
So?
Do you know her?
I know her name. I know that her mother called her Angel.
You know her mother? It's a friend of her mother's I need to find.
Angel. That would make her a fallen angel now, wouldn't it? You must be after Everett.
Yeah, Morgan Everett. How did you guess?
What makes you think Nicolette would betray one of her mother's closest friends?
I helped her friends from Silhouette. Chad will vouch for me. I'm after the people who murdered her mother.
You are an assassin or something?
When necessary.
Go out behind the club. I will talk to Nicolette and perhaps she will meet you there.
New primary goal. Meet Nicolette behind Club La Porte de l'Enfer.
She will insist that you meet her alone. If you are lying, she will not hesitate to kill you. Out back. 5 minutes. Out back. 5 minutes.
All right. Let's head out back
then. I love
then.
This place.
Decided not to show.
I am Nicolette. I will help you simply to make trouble for Majestic 12. It's true. They killed my mother.
Do you know why?
She was an Illuminatus. The only people MJ-12 has ever feared are the Illuminati.
Stan doubts that they had fallen from power.
How do you know Dowd?
I met him in New York.
A trusted friend of my mother's. Yes, the Illuminati are wiped out, but Paige still fears Morgan Everett.
Where do we find him?
One of my mother's many secrets. We'll have to look for clues at my family's chateau.
How does Everett threaten Bob Page?
Page was an Illuminatus. For him, intellect is the foundation of power, and that would make Everett his most dangerous rival.
But Everett's the one in hiding.
Both the Illuminati and MJ-12 believe that the most intelligent or enlightened human being will inevitably gain power, ultimately seizing the eye in the pyramid and creating the world for everyone else. Kind of secularized version of natural law.
Page has a trained army to protect him.
He is still vulnerable. Much of his power comes from secret laboratories, meaning the right person could reverse engineer his whole power base.
Let's hope you're right. That Everett is everything you say he is. Let's go.
You trust the guy in the helicopter?
That's Jock. Don't worry, he hasn't let me down yet. Come on.
300 skill points for finding Nicolette. And we've completed two of our primary goals and made a new one. Search the DuClare Chateau for evidence of Morgan Everett's relationship with Beth DuClare. My skill point total is 2926. Let's leave.
Let's hit it.
Gunther! Alright, here's Chateau DuClare. We'll go ahead and do this map too, and then we'll call it a video. So let's talk to Nicolette again.
I had not wanted to see this place again.
Why not?
I was afraid it would be like this. The same. Not a stone out of place.
You would rather that Majestic 12 had burned it down?
I would rather... No, let's go. Only in novels do places crumble to dust for no reason when their spirit is lost.
Your mother?
Lead the way. I no longer have a key. We must find my mother's secret computer room, where she did all her work. A place she kept hidden, even from me.
New goal. Find Beth DuClare's secret computer room, which should contain clues to the whereabouts of Morgan Everett. Since we finished that map, I'll go ahead and make a new real save right quick. I have to say, for some reason, I really like the Chateau DuClare map. Maybe just because it's empty for the most part and you just get to explore this big mansion. I don't know.
A good place to start would be my mom's bedroom, upstairs. My mother and I were no longer speaking at the time of her death. I left home because she and her Illuminati cronies were always pushing me into things. I was a rotten student, but that didn't stop them from getting me enrolled at La Sorbonne. I was a stand-in for the world they never got to take over. Some conspiracy, huh? They couldn't even control little Nicolette. This place sure is quiet. Right to the very end, my mother believed they were going to stitch the group back together and rule the world. Pitiful, if you think about it. Like a senile old lady filling her house with the unopened boxes from mail-order sweepstakes. But my mother was remarkable in her own way. I overheard her tell Everett one night that she had calculated Majestic 12's private key. Right here, where I grew up, she was tracking a global conspiracy and trying to do something about it. She had a secret computer room, some kind of monitoring station. I heard her talk about it, but I never found the entrance. Even when we were on bad terms, I continued to deliver money to Silhouette because I knew how important they were to my mother's plans. I also wanted to help Chad. A group like Silhouette has a lot to gain from an alliance with the Illuminati in the short term. In the long term, well, if my mother had been successful, we would be trying to stop the Illuminati right now instead of Majestic 12. Where now? Dull place to grow up, huh? I'm so glad I moved to the city. You lead. This place sure is quiet.
All right. I really like the music on this map, too. Front door's locked. We could blow it open or pick it open, but I'd rather not do that just yet. Let's explore the outside. There are no enemies on this map until the very end. Out back, we have what looks like some family crypts. After we get through this little maze, anyway.
Several different families are buried here, going back to the original builder, a French merchant of the 19th century.
This place sure is quiet.
I don't think there's anything in this little maze, either. The back door's boarded up, but I think we can bust it open. And then it's unlocked. Make sure there's nothing over here. And we'll head through the back door.
Crazy. I lost my virginity out here. I believe Mom was out conspiring to get me into La Sorbonne at the time.
I'm pulling up the floor plan. An old summer home built during the Third Republic. It's been vacant since Miss DuClare's assassination. Hopefully these elegant rooms contain some clues about the DuClare family's involvement with the Illuminati.
All right, we got a multi-tool
Mom and
here.
Everett used to sit out here sipping martinis and plotting to take over the world. That's how we all got in this mess.
There's a multi-tool on the shelf there. Well, here's the front doors.
My mom had that couch flown in from Portugal. Exactly the same as what she could have bought at La Samaritaine, except that it was once graced by the bottoms of a royal family.
See, we got a bottle of wine in here. Nothing else. See, we could get upstairs in here, but let's not do that just yet. Let's finish exploring the ground level first, if we can.
I don't know if this will help, but I used to use that computer whenever I was at home. The last time was just before my mother was killed. The login is Nicolette. The password is Chad.
New note, Nicolette's computer in the study. Login Nicolette, password Chad. All right, let's do it. Nicolette, Chad. From Chad, subject Silhouette Business. Nicolette, your aid in securing support for Silhouette has been invaluable. You've done much to help sustain the cause of freedom in the face of ever more open repression by our own government. However, I'm afraid that I must ask for your help yet again. The police have begun to raid the catacombs, and if we are to put up an effective resistance, then we must locate additional resources by whatever means necessary. I know your mother and her friends wish to remain anonymous, but any funds or material that they can contribute will be of enormous help. And even if they cannot, their continued goodwill is still of great importance to us all. Thank you, and I hope to see you again soon. Chad. From Beth DuClare. Subject, regarding your help. They need help or they'll be slaughtered by the porks who strut about the streets like they own them. You've helped us once before, and it has meant so much to the cause. Please, Mother, I'm asking you to help us again. You know so many who can... I will do what I can, dear, but the situation is far more complicated than I think you may be aware of. My connections within The Hague and the United Nations indicate that the problem is not limited to France, and many parties are using the Grey Death epidemic as an excuse to exercise their control over other national governments. I have to consult with Morgan. We must be careful where we choose to allocate our resources. It is a very dangerous time for everyone, Nicolette, and your flirtation with this organization could have serious consequences. I am asking you again to be careful. I could not stand it if something happened to you. In the meanwhile, I will do what I can. Beth. Out here we got cigarettes.
You will find no one to help you here. Beth DuClare has been dissected.
And a bottle of wine. I really like Icarus. There's another multi-tool on top of the fireplace. I find his taunts much more effective than Gunther's. Mainly because I feel like there's good reason to be afraid of Icarus. Not so much with Gunther. Dining room, we got two wine bottles. We head into the kitchen. There's another multi-tool.
The maid did all of the cooking, but Mom always picked out the wine. She was the only one with a key to the cellar.
You can ride the dumbwaiter upstairs. That's one way to get there. There's soy food in here and a newspaper. Exclusive, Bob Page.
Funny, you know, when I was a little girl, I used to play in the dumbwaiter that goes up to Mom's room. Amazing, I didn't break my neck.
Exclusive, Bob Page interview, Affaires La France. AF, and now France? Yes, France. France and Europe have prospered for thousands of years. It would be foolish to ignore the economic and cultural opportunities that exist here. This country has a huge reserve of talent in all sectors of the workforce, and Page Industries is looking forward to recruiting the best and the brightest. But what about the turmoil that seems to be afflicting much of the continent, the rise of radical splinter groups such as Shoes and Silhouette? Intimidation through violence is the last resort of the weak. These groups are composed of nothing but frustrated, gullible individuals. We have a very effective security organization that will be working with both local and national authorities to minimize whatever potential for actual harm they present. So you see yourself working closely with the government. Very closely. Wine cellar's locked. We could break in, but there's no need. Now let's head over here and go upstairs.
A secret room in the upper part of the house would have been very difficult to conceal. Look for clues in Beth's room. I bet she had a quick way to get to the cellar.
That door is locked. This one's unlocked. Looks like a very fancy bathroom. There's a med kit in here. And a key. Nick to Nicolette's bedroom.
What are you looking for?
And a pepper gun.
I think my mother kept a room key behind a little vase up here.
So she did. Beth's bedroom key. That would be Beth's room. I want to go to Nicolette's room first. Two throwing knives and a candy bar. A soda.
My little prison for 18 years.
She's got a skull on her fireplace mantle. That's cute. And a book by her bed.
I wanted to be in the city, but I guess Mom thought it was easier to keep her activities secret in the country.
Richard III, we've already read. And she's got a lockpick on her nightstand. You hit the skull, of course, it opens up a little secret. A zyme vial, which we no longer have any use for. A lockpick, a thermoptic camo, a clip modification, and a plasma clip. All of which are useless to me. Let's go to Beth's room now. It's worth 100 skill points to get in here. Brings me to 3,026.
My mom's room. And look, her favorite painting. I can't believe the assassins didn't take it. Oh, the hours she would spend just sitting at that table and staring up at her priceless treasure.
All right. There's another key to Nicolette's bedroom. Nothing in the basket. A book. Jacob's Shadow by Andrew Hammond, chapter 27. It was late when he got back, everything black and quiet. Jacob killed the lights, but didn't take the key out of the ignition. He reached into his pocket and took out a little box with an LCD display, thumbed a button, and the radio transceiver captured the last few hours' worth of motion sensor logs from the building. He'd done some favors for friends in the shop, or whatever it was they were calling it this week, and they'd installed it to spec for him. As he walked to the door, he was still arranging all the pieces in his head. Sure way to get his ass taken down, but he couldn't help it. Something was missing. Didn't fit. Allie hunched over in the bathroom, that needle dangling from between her toes. Katsuya shifting a half million yen before the currency market closed. The radio station Samuel had turned him onto, the one with the little girl repeating all those numbers in sequence, and somewhere in the middle. Jacob stopped, looking up at the night sky. He'd been assuming that there were two sides to this game and both were playing to win. But what if? What if there was someone else and they wanted to see both sides lose? So here's the dumbwaiter, which we could have taken up from the kitchen. Here we've got flare darts, and a crossbow. And of course, behind the painting, we find a DuClare basement key, 100 credits, a reload mod, which I'll put on the Gep gun, and a data cube. Dear Nicolette, at some point it may become necessary for you to access my private records and perhaps to do what you think best given the circumstances of my absence. You must understand how much I care for you, and if I've not always done what might be considered right, I have always done what I thought best for you and the others I've cared about. It is a cold heart that does not have some regrets. Login, BDuClare, password, Nico_Angel. This is all I can leave to you, everything else I have already given. I love you, my daughter, and I trust you will make me proud. I am only sorry that I am not here to see it. Beth. Alright. So now we need to head back down to the kitchen and then into the cellar. Nicolette's in the habit of shutting some doors behind her. An annoyance, but a minor one.
In France, the gentry keep their wine in a small cellar to preserve the flavor from heat and sunlight.
We got 150 skill points for entering the cellar, brought me to 3176. There's a lockpick in that crate. I don't think there's anything else in the wine cellar, but this is very obvious. Hit the candelabra. We open a secret door.
Owner to hide Jewish families. The DuClares acquired the property after the Nazis sent him to a camp in Germany. Strange. I'm picking up heavy-duty fiber optic activity down here.
What's this? A dungeon?
We got another 150 skill points for finding the bunker. I'm up to 3326. So here, inside the bunker, we've got some sabo rounds.
My mother would not have worked in this filth. There must be another room.
Oh no!
Can break that down with one whack from the dragon's tooth. As you can see, there's a vent we can get into up here. Go ahead and do that. Got a lockpick here. And a window into the computer room, as well as another lockpick over there. I'm not particularly worried about either.
God!
Let's just take the main drag here. Got a law, and another lockpick, and a security computer. Turn the camera off, unlock and open the nanotech crate. Well, I think the dragon's tooth can handle this, too.
That's not funny.
Some kind of giant routing station. Not on any telecom map I've ever seen. Petabytes of transmission. Beth DuClare's probably used it to analyze net traffic.
So that completed one of our primary goals.
Oh my god.
And we get 250 skill points for finding this room. I'm up to 3576. There's a bioelectric cell.
I had no idea.
A multi-tool, an accuracy mod, which, yes, I have no use for. Another biocell. We'll tap the computer in just a minute. First, though, well, I know that's useless. I already have my full suite of AUGs. But there's an upgrade canister here. Haven't found one of those in a while. Let's get my power recirculator to tech... No. Let's get radar transparency to tech 3. That seems like the best use of it. Now, if we head over here, we find flare darts, regular darts, and a repair bot. Let's go ahead and tap the computer. Well, we don't have to tap it. The login is BDuClare, and the password is Nico_Angel. Email from Morgan Everett, subject final message. Cipher block. This will be our last communication over the net. The so-called Aquinas protocols that my old protege and MJ-12 have implemented are crude but effective, much like my protege. All future meetings will need to occur face-to-face at a secure location. To expedite matters, I will deliver to you a tear sheet chip. It will contain 20 codes and their corresponding keys. Each code and key pair can be used once, and then it will be permanently erased. Each code will be tagged to one of our previously agreed upon meeting locations and times. If one or the other of us should need to get in touch, send a message using one of the codes. The content of the message is irrelevant, only the code used to encrypt it. I shouldn't need to point out that any attempt to tamper with the chip once it has been installed will result in it being rendered useless. Best of luck to you and to us all, Morgan. And special options, transmit M. Everett meeting signal. Secure channel signal sent to M. Everett.
So you found Beth's computer. We are destined to meet, perhaps. If you are truly our rabbi, you will help me access the MJ-12 computer network and complete the Grey Death vaccine. Find Nicolette. You will need her key in order to exit through the crypt. I will be directing you to a nearby cathedral.
What is it?
A transmission from Morgan Everett. He wants me to go out the back way through the crypt to a nearby cathedral.
The Cathedral of the Knights Templar?
He didn't say. I'm supposed to access the Majestic 12 computer network.
Yes, Majestic 12 controls the place now. They killed the Knights for their gold reserves. Everett must want you to sneak to that part of town through the sewers that connect to our property.
I thought the Templars vanished centuries ago.
They invented the modern banking system and were its directors, under one name or another, until Majestic 12 took over.
He said you had a key.
Yes, here it is. The crypt is in the maze behind the chateau. Listen to Everett. He is right to want to avenge the Templars.
All right. Bunch of goals completed. And we got a new primary goal. Go to the family crypt in the maze behind the chateau and await instructions from Morgan Everett.
The Templars inherited the gold of the original French treasury, which was run by a Templar until the order was suppressed. Just before the crackdown in 1307, the gold was secretly moved to a cathedral, where it has remained ever since. The Nazis plundered a third of it during World War II, but most of the gold remains. Let's keep moving. I'll go with you as far as the maze. MJ-12 could be loading the gold onto a plane right now. Let's keep moving.
All right. Alright, now we have a few troopers to deal with in the maze, but nothing too serious. New primary goal, access the Templar computer system so that Morgan Everett can complete work on a cure for the Grey Death.
I'll go with you as far as the maze.
Another one right at the crypt.
Locked on.
Dang.
Funny reading.
Well, I've got more time than I thought I had.
Exit the DuClare estate through the crypt at the end of the maze. The system I need you to access is inside a cathedral that belonged to the Knights Templar until MJ-12 slaughtered the Knights for the gold reserves.
Okay, let's save now.
Look out, JC, I'm picking up heat signatures in the sewers. I think somebody's expecting you.
To go through some of my mother's things.
Think we're good.
Good luck. Everett will be a powerful ally, but you can be certain that he will have his own agenda. I'm going to stay to go through some of my mother's things.
All right, later, Nicolette. Yeah, just two commandos. Nothing too serious.
Hunter, I've got contact.
I can just get that one shot on him.
Target locked. Locked on.
Dang it.
Funny reading.
I do hate these guys. Come on now.
Got it.
Alright. He's got nothing. And he's got nothing. Let's go ahead and hit the map change. 150 skill points for getting into here. That takes me to 3726, and I will finally upgrade lockpicking to advanced.
Try to ignore the smell. This sewer connects to a street near the cathedral, not too far from here.
All right, through the sewer. I don't... The Knights Templar Cathedral is another map that I like a lot, but I believe that that is sufficient for a video. So, I'll update all my saves, make a new one at the start of the new map, and I will call that an installment. This has been Let's Play Deus Ex. I will see you guys next time for the Templar Cathedral. Bye-bye.